I am pleased to welcome Mr. Ganesh Sawaleshwarkar to present the case study.
Good afternoon. It's the most difficult portion of the day, just after the lunch. I have enjoyed my lunch. I hope you have enjoyed your lunch. And after lunch, normally whenever I have attended any training programs or such conferences, the best time is to have a short 100 winks in a cool atmosphere. And I would not normally like to disturb you, but I hope that you can spare some few moments between your winks to whatever I have to present to you. So today here I'm going to present a case study of the IT modernization project that is being implemented in Department of Post. This is a journey from a post office, an old type building, to a e-environment. This is what this journey is about. This is the agenda. I will try to give you an overview of India Post to put in perspective as to the background on which this project has been formulated. This will help us in better appreciating the context and the nature of the project, understanding the realities or the background or the realities in the Department of Post. Department of Post is a typical government organization, but has a special place in each one of our hearts. I can dare say that each one of you present in this hall has been a postal customer sometime in your life. So after having an overview, we'll have the details of the project, and then we'll end up with our question answer session. So having a brief introduction to what Department of Post is about, it is a part of Ministry of Communication and IT. It's a 160-year-old organization. First October 1854, this was formed, and in next 15 days, we'll be completing 160 years. Department of Post was basically organized or constituted mainly for delivery of mail, and has been a mainstay of the communication in India. However, since for its functioning, it required to establish many post offices in different nooks and in the nook and corner of the country, this physical network was used for various small savings, to mobilize the small savings, to provide the life insurance security. In 1884, we started postal life insurance. The postal small savings services started in 1875. And the other retail agency services were run through the Department of Post. The waste distribution and the social service, the social security benefits were also discharged through Department of Post. I have read in the history books of Department of our India Post that even quinine tablets were distributed through the post office. It is the world's largest postal network, having 1,55,000 outlets, of which 130,000 are in the rural areas. India has 6 lakh villages, so every fifth village is having a post office. The average distance to the nearest post office is just 2 kilometers. So it is about 25 minutes walk to the nearest post office. About 5 lakh employees, they are reducing day by day. Because of induction of technology, the number of employees required is not very high. And in the last 25 years since we have started our computerization, in various stages, 25,000 post offices have been computerized. Now, these 25,000 are all departmentally run post offices. The remaining 130,000, which I'm talking about rural post offices, are run by Gramin Dak Sevak, which is a separate model about which we will talk on some other day. About the numbers have their own beauty. They convey meaning in a very direct manner. This will give you an idea as to the various activities of Department of Post. Can you put on this TV on? Mail is decreasing. Last 5 years, 7% decrease of mail is there. The registered mail volume, about 4% has decreased. But speed post has increased by nearly over 100%. Saving banks, numbers, today, it is more than this, but 3 years back, 2 years back, it was 28,74,31,078 number of accounts in the Postal Saving Bank. The amount in deposit is 6 lakh crore rupees. It is just next to the State Bank of India. The Postal Life Insurance is a service which has a fund value of nearly 23,000 crores. Number of lives, insured lives are near 50 lakh. Postal Life Insurance is mainly for the government and the public sector employees. But rural postal life insurance is open for everybody. And that fund value in last 20 years has increased to nearly 9,000 crores, with nearly 1 crore 35 lakhs lives being insured. And mail motor distance, that is the red van that you see on the road, which the distance covered in a year is 327.5 lakh kilometers. To put it in perspective, it is 86 times the distance from Earth to Moon. It is about, for 5 years, if I run like this, I will reach Sun. So I just given these figures to give you an idea as to the size of the department. It is as representative as me, so you will get an idea as to how difficult it is to modernize the department with this size and this figure. Just a picture, nostalgia about the post office. We all associate nostalgia with post office. The one, this is the Panji post office. That is the Darjeeling post office, the Shimla post office, and the floating post office in Srinagar. These two, just to give an idea as to at all kinds of places we are there. At Leh, I have seen a post office in Gangotri, which runs only for 6 months, because other 6 months there is snow. Few other pictures. This grand building is a temporary building erected for the Kumbh Mela in Allahabad. This is the reality of post office in rural India, where common man finds ease to do business with him. Can you cite any other government department where you can sit at such ease in that main office? Any other government department? But while this reality is there, even the next two also is the reality. We have the aircraft, which is now not being run, but it was being run for nearly 3 years. And this is the Leh, Kargil, Srinagar mail van that used to run, that is still running. Just after history, let us come to the project, because we are all interested in project. And I believe now in last, say, 5 to 6 minutes, you might have taken your 100 wings and now got ready to hear about the project. The computerization started in 1992 in department. It all started with the standalone operations being computerized, the mail booking being computerized, the saving bank being computerized, then some attempts to put the local level land for the computerization of a post office. But still, till about 2000 or this new century, one post office was not talking to another post office. And that happened after we had a speed post tracking, end-to-end tracking, where the data used to flow from one place to another. And by 2008, about all the post offices got computerized. And the challenge now was to take advantage of this IT network and let this network talk to each other and maximize the benefit. At this moment, I was a part and parcel of a team there where we had a brainstorming and thought that we need to start from a clean slate. We need to undertake the business process reengineering, and that was done. And these were the other facts that we had in our mind while designing this project. The last decade, that is the first decade of the century, the mail was declining, the parcel business was increasing, so a new area was increasing. The e-commerce was taking its baby steps. Opportunities in the other new sectors were increasing. The social security benefits from the government of India were coming in big time. In 2007, when the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme was launched, I was working at Karnool in Andhra Pradesh. I was in charge of the Rayalaseema area, and it was launched at Anantapur. I still remember the day when on 22nd February 2007 it was launched. And I remarked to somebody that whether this employment guarantee scheme will give employment to rural people or not, I don't know, but it is definitely guarantees the employment of post office. Because this is not going to end. Similarly, the advances in ICT, the information and communication technology, gave us an opportunity to think very big, and enterprise-wide dreams could be undertaken. So in short, declining core business, new technology, business, the emerging areas of business opportunities, and the competition increasing, the IT literacy amongst employees increasing, customer needs are changing, market needs are changing, customer expectations are changing, and the government of India giving higher focus, higher stress on digital inclusion. This word inclusion is nowadays very much used in vogue in the department, to include all the digital divides, to bridge the digital divides between the Bharat and India. And e-governance initiatives were taken in all sectors. So it was expected that the Department of Post also contributes to that. So with this background, this IT project was designed and planned. So we undertook the business process reengineering in 2008-2009. The vision, mission, and the business objectives were revisited, restated, revised. And the aim was to reach to the customers, to focus their requirement, and to grow in the new areas of business. While doing this, we had a very important stakeholder in mind, that is the employees. We have customers in mind, we have organizational needs in mind, organizational goals in mind, but the employees with whom we are going to work, even their needs were taken care of, and their requirement was kept as an important aspect of the project, where their interaction with the organization was also made as a part of this project. And now when we undertake training on this project, in the first 5 minutes, I tell to our employees who have come for training, these are the things that you will gain personally by implementing the project. Like, you can submit your personal claims online, you will get all your advances online, your promotion, your other things will be done online. There will be greater transparency. Immediately, everybody is active. Everybody is open, with has their ears open and ready for understanding what the project is. So that is a very important aspect of this project, where an important stakeholder, that is employee, has been taken care of. The project scope is about 5,000 crore rupees project. This includes operational cost for running the project for running the services on this system for 5 years after the completion of project. And this project was divided into 8 functional areas. The first three areas, the core system integrator, the financial services system integrator, and the rural ICT system integrator are the software related aspects of the project. The rural ICT hardware and the mail operations hardware are the hardware supply related aspects of the project, areas of the project. And the data center and the network integrator is relating to the network integration of all the post offices. Whereas network integrating implies integrating putting all the post office on a single network, on a single WAN. And data center is the place because where everything can be, all the systems will access the data. And change management, the 8th one, is to galvanize the whole organization to accept this project for implementation. So you can see these first 7 are like the 7 steps that we take, like a saptapadi, and the 8th is the person who takes you for the lifelong journey. This is what the project is about. And therefore, 8 separate RFPs were issued. In nutshell, this is what the project is. This is the outline of the IT solution, where the 5 silos, the mail operations, postal banking, the postal life insurance, the HRMS, the human resource management system, and the payroll, and finance accounts. These 5 verticals are there, of which postal banking and postal life insurance form the part of FSI, that is the financial service integrator. The mail operations, HRMS, and finance account form the part of the CSI, along with web portal, mobile banking, call centers, and the customer interaction channels. Rural ICT is a separate solution. The MIS reporting and the IT infrastructure is the foundation upon which this whole thing stands and is supported by the data warehouse. This is how the IT solution has been designed. These are the impact areas, benefits for the citizens, benefits for the government, benefits for the DOP. DOP is Department of Post. We use the word Department of Post and India Post interchangeably. I will not go into details of this because we'll have some other areas, important areas to cover. The governance structure, that is the project team which is going to run this project, which is running this project. At the apex level is the steering committee, where the involvement of finance ministry and the other ministries are there, who steer the project, who move the project. The project coordination committee is a high level committee which oversees the project. And the implementation committees is the project implementation committee. And they are supported by these core areas. There are various subcommittees. I am a member of 2 or 3 subcommittees there. As a change management committee, I am a member. I am a member of the HR subcommittee, the CSI. And also, I am a nodal officer for the digitization, which I will come to later. And I am also called sometimes to advise to the project implementation committee on some areas. This is how the delegation and the escalation happens in the governance. The details of the role, the areas that these various committees play. The architecture review committee is for implementing the change management project which are not mentioned in that structure, and to resolve the day-to-day issues that come up with the vendors. In addition to this is the top level at the headquarter level. These two committees are at the field level. The postal organization is divided for the administrative purposes into circles. Circles are roughly states, and the circles are having regions under them. Regions are having are like roughly a commissionerate area. Like in AP, if we take, AP is a circle. Still, AP is a circle. Telangana is a region. Rayalaseema is a region. And Vijayawada is a region. And Vishakhapatnam is a region. The proposal for bifurcation of the circle has gone. It is, the approval is awaited. I have to be politically correct when I'm standing in Hyderabad. So these regional implementation committees will be the last mile or the last point of implementation for the project. Accenture is our technical consultant who is with us for last 5 years for designing the project, planning and monitoring. They have helped us design the RFPs. The project is implemented, as I told you, through 8 different contracts. The core subcommittees are engaging the vendors, their various development teams to develop their business blueprint, the user acceptance test cases, and conducting the UAT. First, the project is being rolled out in the pilot offices, and thereafter, a review will be taken and the final rollout will happen. This is how the project will be executed. Or the tricky areas, the challenges that we face as a government organization, and especially for this project, since there are 8 areas, 8 different partners or vendors as we call it, their coordination is a challenge. As of now, 5 vendors are on board and they are working. 3 more are coming on board in this next week or so. But with 5 vendors on the board, we are facing some problems, some challenges, not say problems, but challenges. And integrating these various systems at technical level and at the project level is also a big challenge. And now we are envisaging another challenge is when we roll out this project in 150,000 locations, the project management areas and the those skills that we hope we have at all levels, that is a challenge area for us. In addition to that, 70 lakh employee records are required to be scanned and digitized. Over 20 crore data entry records fields have to be recorded. Training of over 5 lakh employees is to be undertaken. And since this project is a big project, a long-drawn project, there will be changes. It's a government organization. Promotions happen, retirement happen, transfers happen. How to maintain a continuity in project governance is also a big challenge. I will not call challenges as risk because in your PMBOK, it is classified as risk. But government, when you do business with government, there is no risk. There are always challenges. So this is one of the area is to transfer institutional knowledge to the system development teams. This is, I believe, is one of the biggest challenges we are finding. Because the system development teams or the vendor teams, they speak a language different than us. And I understand a language different than them. My conceptual understanding is different. Theirs is different. I think that I know more than them. They think that they know more than me. And therefore, somehow a mean has to be arrived at, and that is a challenge. Anybody who is working with government organizations or government, this is a key area which you have to work to. And for the vendor solution, when he submits it for acceptance, the various parameters that are to be applied, ambiguity is normally there when the project is designed in 2011-2012, and now we are implementing it in 2015-2014. There some developments have happened, aspirations have changed, and which, if they are not there in the RFP, it leads to some problems for accepting. Because we know what we are accepting is wrong with the today's realities, but still we have to accept it because it is there in the RFP. Project of such type and at this scale has not been attempted in Government of India. And quality monitoring issues is also a challenge which I find is a key area which any project manager has to keep in mind while handling such kind of projects. Can I continue? Yeah. At present, as I told you, five areas are already ruling. The data center and disaster recovery center has been established. Network integration has been completed, making India Post van the world's largest van. The CBS has been rolled out. CBS is the core banking solution. It has been done by the Infosys. The life insurance solution has been also done by Infosys. The change management activities are in full swing, that is being handled by TCS. The core system integrator is the TCS. They are also at the stage of UAT. Other three vendors for hardware and rural systems, they are coming on board in a week. This is the world's largest SAP implementation project, one of the largest change management projects, and on completion, it will be world's largest IT network physical service center, the India Post. With this, we can come for the questions. I think I have overshot by a minute. Yes, sir.
Are you using any field force automation for customer delivery?
Pardon?
Are you using any field force automation, like courier people are using?
Or see, there are two aspects in mail operations. Two aspects in mail operation. One is the physical sorting of mail, automation in that. And second is the IT backbone for carrying the information regarding the speed post article. Okay. For ordinary mail, there is already automated machines are there. At Mumbai, at Chennai, at Kolkata and Delhi. For ordinary mail. The speed post traffic doesn't warrant an automated solution for sorting. For sorting. But for the information sharing, the end-to-end tracking is available for Speedpost even today. And it is there for the last 3 years. And this will be there in the new project also, the new solution also. Have I answered your question?
Sir, I'm having a small question about the motivation.
No, I think he has to rebound question. No,
my question is that fields, the courier people are using field force for the acknowledgement. So do you have
In this project it is there. Handheld devices are there, yeah.
Yeah, mobile apps or something like
that.
Yeah,
it is there. I'll show. Laptop handheld devices is for the postman. Thank you for clarifying the question. Because normally what happens, sometimes I get a question regarding the grievances about post offices. So I thought, is it a grievance of post office or what? Sorry to have misunderstood you. Yes, sir, it is. Another question was coming from this side.
I am asking a question about the motivation of the end users.
Where are you?
Oh. I'm here.
Yeah.
So all the users of this IT system belongs to the government department. Obviously. So that would be a challenge for you. You face that problem
yes.
to keep them motivated.
Yes, that's what I told you. That here, this is one of the area aims and objectives for in the project vision itself to have high employee satisfaction. Now, one way of achieving this is to take care of their personal things. Every employee has some personal agenda. in any organization, be it government or be it private or public sector. Because and unless that is taken care in your solution, that's what the view was. Unless we give something for them to take home, this project is not going to get acceptance as easily as is expected.
So any age factor comes came into the picture?
Age factor comes. I'll tell you one example. I am a director of a training center, a postal training center. 2 years back, I got a trainee who was promoted from postman to a postal assistant. His age was 58 and a half years. He was going to retire in 1.5 years. And our 100% training is on computer for postal assistant who work on counters. He had come from Indore, named Mr. Pandey. I told him, Pandey ji, aap kahe ke liye aaye ho yahan par? Aram se rehte, deir saal mein aap retire ho jate. Kaha computer ke chakkar mein phas rahe? Because he failed in 3 examination. He said, nahi sir, main postman man ke jindagi bhar raha hoon. Postman man ke mujhe retire nahi hona hai.
Okay. Hello.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
And all credit to him, he passed the next examinations and he was not last in the class.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a question.
Yeah.
Yes, you mentioned about working with so many contractors and the coordination was a challenge. If you could share no, one
it's
or...
Still, it was not a challenge. It is still a challenge.
So can you share some experiences of some of the specific challenges faced and how were they resolved? One or two examples.
Let us not take names.
Okay.
Partner A, partner B. A is offering one solution, B is offering another solution, one of them. Now A wants to implement it. Now A somehow has a head start. So he has started rolling out. Now B wants to implement it. He has a reservation not to go on the same steps. Wants to implement it independently first. Because the moment B wants to implement it with A, his integration also will be tested. So this is the challenge where we have to convince both of them to come together right. For my sake.
Right. Okay. Sir, thank you.
Sir, I have one question. Like we are doing the IT modernization for Department of Post currently, whether already private and public sector banking system already implemented and there in market. What is the...
Can you repeat the initial part?
Yeah. The question is like, we are doing the IT modernization for Department of Post now. Already private and public sector banks already in market. What is the real difference the Department of Post will make to compete with other private and public sectors in future?
Yes. I'll come to this figure. This statistic which I showed you. The top two lines are negative. Okay? But see the rural PLI fund value. Plus 204%. Okay? That is the now new area of business. Banks are not there. Couriers are not there. Couriers are not beyond, say, 1,000 cities in India. And India is not 1,000 cities. India is 6 lakh villages. I'm not saying that. Some 100 years back, Gandhiji said it. That India is 6 lakh villages. And that villages are emerging as a new economic power. They need insurance. They need banking facility. If it was not there, why would few days back, Janadhana Yojana would have been launched by the Prime Minister? And why 1 crore accounts were opened in one day? With a target to open 7 crore accounts given to bank. The cake is very big. Everybody has a place. Everybody has a slice. See, I have got not a single competitor. I don't have a courier to compete only. I don't have a bank to compete only. I don't have an insurance provider to compete only. I have all the three competitors and more. That is the challenge. And for an organization like us, I am in the organization for last 20 years. When I was studying my engineering in late 80s and early 90s, I wanted to enter government service to become my Baap Sarkar, not to become a manager or somebody. Okay. By the time I came out and joined the service, government had changed. Its perspective had changed. It was no more a my Baap Sarkar. It was a manager. So I had to become a manager. And today, we are running our work, our doing our work from a business perspective, from marketing perspective, and from providing the services, not as a my Baap Sarkar. So this change has happened. I think sir is waiting for long. Ma'am, please wait.
Thank you, sir, for introducing sir, India Post.
Ma'am, please wait. He is asking one question.
Congratulations, sir, for implementing.
Ma'am, please wait. Ma'am, please wait. He has started his question. Please wait.
So thank you very much for introducing us the great story of IT computerization of India Post, and we take great pride in that. And also in these days of declining customer satisfaction, India Post still remains the most legitimate or satisfying agency from the government, where a customer feels that his letter will be delivered. So. Two questions here. How do you handle, I know sir, part of the question you answered in one of your earlier answers. How do you handle the business from these courier companies that are coming up? Still, I will go, and any of my colleagues will definitely go to speed post to deliver a letter to an university or any organization. Second part is, in these days of flipkarting, do you strike deals with those companies like Myntra or Flipkart to deliver those things so that it can go to the remote villages? Thank you so much.
Yeah. See, the challenges from courier, I'm not taking it in a negative manner. I'm taking it in a positive manner. That has made us look inward, to introspect and to improve. People are going to couriers because there is some need to be satisfied by courier, which we were not satisfying. But still, our mail traffic is, the express traffic is increasing, you can say 119%. The courier market in India is the only last unregulated area of service. Telephones are regulated, electricity are regulated, everything else is regulated, airlines is regulated, but not postal service. You can build house anywhere. You will not get electric connection unless you apply for it, not get telephone connection unless you apply for it. But we expect a letter to be delivered, you are at the top of the hill. You will get a waiting list number if you apply, if you go on IRCTC website, if the quota is full. But letterbox doesn't close its mouth, even if it is full. That is the problem, and that is the challenge we face. Second question is about the customer expectations. They are always changing, and the Flipkart and other such things is a service which has adorned a new avatar. It is like saying that everybody feels that Flipkart is a new thing that has happened. It is not a new thing that has happened. It is a new avatar of an old thing. The value payable parcel service started in India in 1878. I did my SSC in around 86, 87. I was staying in a small place, and I used to order book through VPP, through post office, and I used to pay to the postman. That time, no Flipkart was there. So Flipkart is there, it's today's reality, because what Flipkart has changed or Amazon has changed is the initial touch point between the supplier and the consumer. That he has revolutionized. Not the delivery part. It is the old same. See, you may like to do business on e-banking and everything. Ultimately, you feel joy only when you have currency in the hand. So that physical joy can never replace the virtual reality.
Bitcoin.
Sir, you had a question, sir.
Oh.
So India Post credit card, unfortunately, not a part of this project. But we are in the process of applying for the banking license. That you must have everybody heard.
Yeah.
It is still in the realms of policies. I'm not talking on that. Moment it happens, all these services will flow.
So, one question here, please. Yeah, so this is about the banking license that we just spoke about.
Excuse me.
Last question you can take.
Sorry to say, but we cannot take questions, sir. We are running out of time.
Well, last question you can take.
Last question, please.
Actually, we have got questions on the app also. We have given preference to.
Okay.
You can definitely connect with the speaker, you know, later on in, during the networking break. Thank you, sir. We would like
you
to resume so that we can take the questions at the end.
So at
really sorry, but we have to make up the time, sir.
So at least, ma'am, you will give me at least some time to say thank you?
I said thank you for...
Thank you to them and to you.
Yeah. Sure.
Jai Hind, and thank you. Pardon?
You can take your question from the
app. I have no problem.
Yeah,
you can
sure.
send me. Thank you.
I will ask you now. Please be on stage.
Okay.
So actually during the session, some people have already sent the questions on the application.
Okay.
It's a mobile application for the conference. And I would like to take the question, two questions basically. One is asked by Sanjay Chaudhary. Can you please explain who provides IT infrastructure and software services to India Post, which India Post, which is a mammoth organization? Who provides the IT infrastructure and software services to India Post Office?
In this project?
Yeah.
In this project, there are three IT solutions which are coming up. One is the FSI, second is the FSI Financial Services, second is the CSI, the Core Services, and third is the RSI. The FSI is the Infosys, which is provided is providing is the solution, both for core banking and for life insurance. Core system is being provided by the Tata Consultancy Services. The RSI is being brought on board, so I'm not at liberty to share the name. So this is what it is for the IT solution part.
One more question, can you please elaborate the customer satisfaction with respect to users, user experience in post offices?
With this project or what?
That is not specifically.
So this is a general thing. Anyway, we have our traditional methodology of assessing customer satisfaction. I was going through the statistics for preparing this project. In last 1 year, 10 lakh complaints have been registered with Department of Post. 10 lakh complaints. And the mail delivered is about 650 crores. So even if we say that 1% people complained or even 0.1% people complain, let us extrapolate and see. Our internal survey show that about 90% of our mail, 90 to 92% of our mail gets delivered on time. Now that 8% still is a huge volume. And there might be many cases in this room who may fall in that 8%. So don't take my statistic with a pinch of salt. It is a reality. And unless the customer was satisfied, he would not sit comfortably in the post office, as I showed in the figure. And as I told earlier, the only person with, like, you can fight with a person with whom you are comfortable. And post office is the only person, only government organization with whom you can dare to fight. Not with police fellows, not with revenue fellows, not with IT fellows, IT means income tax, or customs. If I come down, I know many people are going to fight with me, but I can, but that is the level of comfort that you have with the Department of Post. That's the reason. Anything else? Okay.
So I would request Tejas Sura to please come on the stage and give a bouquet and memento to. So Tejas Sura is a region mentor.
Thank you.
So this is a surprise gift for you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, Tejas. So we'll just break for just 5 minutes for a transfer break, and we'll resume in another 2 to 5 minutes.
It's a great honor to be here with you all. I thank PMI for inviting me for this conference, and thank department for nominating me for this conference to present this case study. Thank Mr. Tejas Sura, who incidentally is my classmate from VJTI. He has never appreciated me while in the college. So today at least I got all my dues. Thank you.